So, I actually had a video already made for today. A whole discussion on early access games and the early access game business model, and a bunch of Subnautica background footage of me looking for any kind of new place to build my base. That was the whole thing. That was the whole idea that was going on with good old Subnautica and early access games, unfortunately. However, when I went to go upload it earlier today, I looked at it and said, this isn't very good. I thought it was actually a poorly made video. So I decided not to upload it. Pretty simple, nothing too fancy about it. I was just like, this wasn't that good. I'm gonna play something different. So now I'm on Overwatch instead. And now we're talking about something I care a hell of a lot more about, which is, of course, coffee. You know, as a kid, every time I'd walk past Ralph's or any kind of grocery store and smell coffee beans, I was absolutely repulsed by it. I thought coffee smelled, it just smelled disgusting. It just smelled awful. I hated the smell of coffee. My parents always gave me this look like, just you wait, Taylor. Just you wait. You wait till you get older and you'll be just craving that smell. I thought they were crazy. I thought they were completely crazy. Now here I am, and literally every single morning I go out and get coffee, black coffee cold brew with shots of espresso, because that's just what I do to get through my day.
Can't move. Help.
Kind of near my house is a coffee shop called Pete's Coffee. P-E-E-T-S. With an apostrophe, of course. Bye. Pete's Coffee, I believe, started over in UC Berkeley in Northern California. And, I mean, if there's one thing about Berkeley, it's got a lot of hipster population. And if there's one thing about hipsters you know that they do well, it's coffee. I've noticed in the more college towns and stuff, coffee is done better. And UC Berkeley started this coffee place. And honestly, it's pretty goddamn good. And I adore it. So now every single morning, I go and get some kind of breakfast, whether it be, I don't know, some kind of bagel or shit. And then immediately after that, I go to Pete's Coffee every single time, get my same order every single time, which is the large cold brew with a good old shot of with a shot of espresso, with light ice to make more coffee. And then when I drink about half of it, I put more of my own ice when I get home, because then it just makes it cold again. I have a whole system with my coffee. I never used to drink coffee a bunch until I started doing YouTube. And of course, that makes things so much easier, because nothing is better for getting through like a 4.5 hour stream or a lot of work than just caffeine. Especially now with the second channel being out, the Big Brick Plays Let's Play channel, which, by the way, if you didn't know yet, I just uploaded the first part of a Nier Automata, Automatopoeia, a Japanese excellent ass game, that game. I uploaded the first part of it. I've actually got like 5 parts already made, because I just played that game for maybe 5 hours after drinking a shitload of coffee, and because that game is really fucking good. So yeah, if you want to go ahead and check out that Let's Play, it's in the description, of course. So just, you know. God damn, I really don't want to play Heroes of the Storm. But this is really making me to want to play Heroes of the Storm. Oh my god. For me, coffee and steak share a similar thing when it comes to how well the coffee or steak is made, or ground up, or filtered, or cooked, or whatever you want to call it. See, I prefer straight black coffee, because I feel like straight black coffee is just a tasty, good way to drink coffee. No bullshit inside of it. If the coffee is really good, black coffee is the way to go. I feel like putting cream and sugar in your coffee, while it is definitely a personal preference, is more of a crutch, because the black coffee itself isn't that good. I feel it's the same way with a steak. If the steak is cooked and seasoned and prepared well enough, you don't need to put on like something like A1 sauce onto your steak, because it's already so good. A1 sauce being the cream and sugar for coffee, and of course just regular steak being black coffee, you get the comparison. I've always been someone who really appreciates just the natural taste in things and doesn't want to add a bunch of stuff to adjust or change the flavor. Same way I am with any kind of alcohol. Like, I drink... Oh, god damn. See, I drink whiskey on the rocks or straight. I don't necessarily enjoy putting in a bunch of other stuff. Now, mixed drinks are totally fine, but I feel like if you're doing anything to adjust the kind, like, adjust whiskey itself... Like, whiskey is too... It's too cool on its own. Like, you need to go ahead and drink it straight if it's that good enough of whiskey. I'm the same way with coffee now. If coffee can be drank just completely straight without any issues, then it's some damn good coffee. Nowadays, coffee is pretty much a necessity for me. I need that shit now. Maybe I'm creating a caffeine addiction for myself, which is not necessarily a good thing, but it tastes so good that I just don't care. I want to refrain from saying I can stop at any time, because we all know whenever anyone says that's not necessarily the truth, but I feel like I can. I just want to keep on looking for new kinds of coffee blends, new kinds of ways to make it. Cold brew is one of my favorite things ever, so I want to keep finding new kinds of coffee shops and places that just make it that way. That's just so goddamn good. With that being said, hope you enjoyed today's Monday vlog. Very simple, talking about coffee, so it obviously, like I mentioned before, I just kind of ramble in these kinds of things, and I can't hit shit with Zenyatta. I would love to be good at Zenyatta, but I have such bad aim with this guy. And of course, you know, gotta hit you with the quick Monday Loot Crate sponsorship. If you want to check out any of the themes, go ahead and look at the description. It's lootcrate.com/Bricky and promo code Bricky for 10% off your purchase. Of course, you know how it goes. And now, before I leave, per the new norm now, we have the Twitch clip of... Yes, got him. Twitch clip of the week. All right, I'll see you next time. Soon, as I try attempt to win this game by freezing Mercy. I'm sorry, Mercy, I love... Oh, okay, I died anyway. Ah, well, it's Random Heroes. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. We travel the same path. Oh! Be gone, thought!